The chain of command is as follows. President, the Honorable Barack H. Obama. Secretary of Defense, the Honorable Charles T. Hagel. Secretary of the Air Force, the Honorable Michael B. Donnelly. U.S. Air Force Chief of Staff, General Mark A. Welsh III. AETC Commander, General Edward A. Rice Jr. AU Commander, Lieutenant General David S. Fadock. Home Center Commander, Brigadier General Robert D. Thomas. AFROTC Commander, Colonel Jefferson S. Dunn. U.S. Air Force MAGCOMs are as follows. Air Mobility Command, Scott Air Force Base, Illinois. Air Combat Command, Joint Base Langley-Eustis, Virginia. AETC, Joint Base San Antonio-Randolph, Texas. Air Force Space Command, Peterson Air Force Base, Colorado. Air Force Special Ops Command, Hurlburt Field, Florida. United States Air Forces in Europe, Ramstein Air Base, Germany. Pacific Air Forces, Joint Base Pearl Harbor Hickam, Hawaii. Air Force Materiel Command, Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, Ohio. Air Force Reserve Command, Robins Air Force Base, Georgia. Air Force Global Strike Command, Barksdale, Louisiana. The Air Force mission is as follows: to fly, fight, and win in air, space, and cyberspace. The Home Center mission is as follows: develop the best Air Force leaders and citizens of character dedicated to serving the nation. The AFROTC mission is as follows: develop quality leaders for the Air Force. The AFROTC field training mission is as follows: train and evaluate cadets for potential entry into the professional officer course. The Air Force Code of Conduct is as follows. Article 1 is as follows. I am an American, fighting the forces which guard my country and our way of life. I am prepared to give my life in their defense. Article 2 is as follows. I will never surrender of my own free will. If in command, I will never surrender the members of my command while they still have the means to resist. Article 3 is as follows. If I am captured, I will continue to resist by all means available. I will make every effort to escape and aid others to escape. I will accept neither parole nor special favors from the enemy. Article 4 is as follows. If I become a prisoner of war, I will keep faith in my fellow prisoners. I will give no information nor take part in any action which might be harmful to my comrades. If I am senior, I will take command. If not, I will obey the lawful orders of those appointed over me and back them up in every way. Article 5 is as follows. When questioned, should I become a prisoner of war, I am required to give name, rank, service number, and date of birth. I will evade answering further questions to the utmost of my ability. I will make no oral or written statements disloyal to my country and its allies or harmful to their cause. Article 6 is as follows. I will never forget that I am an American, fighting for freedom, responsible for my actions, and dedicated to the principles which made my country free. I will trust in my God and in the United States of America. The General Robert E. Lee quote is as follows. Duty, then, is the sublimest word in the English language. You should do your duty in all things. You can never do more. You should never wish to do less. The General Joseph L. Collins quote is as follows. The American people rightly look to their military leaders to be not only skilled in the technical aspects of the profession of arms, but to be men of integrity. The General Omar Bradley quote is as follows. Leadership is intangible, therefore no weapon ever designed can replace it. The quote by General Nathan Twining is as follows. If our air forces are never used, they have achieved their finest goal. The General Dwight D. Eisenhower quote is as follows. If I didn't have air supremacy, I wouldn't be here. The General Curtis E. LeMay, former Chief of Staff of the U.S. Air Force, is as follows. I don't mind being called tough, because in this racket, it's tough guys who lead the survivors. The General Ulysses S. Grant quote is as follows. In every battle, there comes a time when both sides consider themselves beaten. Then he who continues the attack wins. The John Stuart Mill quote is as follows. War is an ugly thing, but not the ugliest of things. The decayed and degraded state of moral and patriotic feeling, which thinks that nothing is worth war, is much worse. The person who has nothing for which he is willing to fight, nothing which is more important than his own personal safety, is a miserable creature and has no chance of being free unless made and kept so by the exertions of better men than himself. The quote by General Charles A. Gabriel, former Chief of Staff of the U.S. Air Force, is as follows. Integrity is a fundamental premise for military service in a free society. Without integrity, the moral pillars of our military strength, public trust, and self-respect are lost. The quote by Father Dennis Edward O'Brien, former Sergeant of the U.S. Marine Corps, is as follows. It is the soldier, not the reporter, who has given us the freedom of the press. It is a soldier, not the poet, who has given us the freedom of speech. It is a soldier, not the campus organizer, who has given us the freedom to demonstrate. It is a soldier who salutes the flag, who serves beneath the flag, and whose coffin is draped by the flag, who allows the protester to burn the flag. The Alfred Thayer Mahan quote is as follows. War, once declared, must be waged offensively, aggressively. The enemy must not be fended off, but smitten down. You may then spare him every exaction, relinquish every gain, but till then he must be struck incessantly and remorselessly. The quote by General George S. Patton, Jr., U.S. Army, is as follows. There's only one sort of discipline, perfect discipline. Men cannot have good battle discipline and poor administrative discipline. The quote by General Daniel S. Chappie James, U.S. Air Force, is as follows. The power of excellence is overwhelming. It is always in demand, and nobody cares about its color. The Airman's Creed is as follows. I am an American airman. I am a warrior. I have answered my nation's call. I am an American airman. My mission is to fly, fight, and win. I am faithful to a proud heritage, a tradition of honor, and a legacy of valor. I am an American airman, guardian of freedom and justice, my nation's sword and shield, its sentry and avenger. I defend my country with my life. I am an American airman, wingman, leader, warrior. I will never leave an airman behind. I will never falter, and I will not fail.